Hello, my name is Abdullah, and in this video I will be discussing the plant processes of phototropism and gravitropism. So phototropism is the plant movement that is caused by light, and gravitropism is plant movement that is caused by gravity. Why do plants need phototropism or gravitropism? Well, this is because the plant needs to maximize its survival in environments, and phototropism and gravitropism gives it that advantage to maximize its survival. How phototropism works is quite simple. It's a chemical and mechanical process. I have a demonstration over here with a piece of paper. If you imagine that piece of paper is the plant shoot, over here we have the meristem of the plant. Here is where auxin is produced. Auxins are produced like the meristem and are transported along the shoot. However, they accumulate on the shade side of the shoot. So if there is a light source coming this way, the auxin is going to be on that side of the shoot. This will cause this side of the shoot to elongate, causing the plant to bend toward the light. If we have leaves over here, that means that the leaves are directly facing the light, maximizing its photosynthetic rate and giving it a survival advantage. This is done because auxin alters the plant cell wall plasticity, making it easier for the plant to grow, or at least for one side to grow, which will bend it towards the light. The methodology of this experiment consists of using what is known as time-lapse video. This is a basic filmography technique. It uses a principle where the camera takes the picture every 1 minute or every 1.5 minutes and then combines it all together to make a video. A regular movie or a video will be 60 or 30 frames per second. That means the camera takes 30 pictures every 1 second to make a video. In time lapse, the camera takes one picture every 1 minute and then it combines it all to create a video that is showing 30 pictures every 1 second. That will make the video look faster or sped up, which is what time lapse is. The hypothesis for my experiment is as follows. Since auxin is produced in the meristem, if the meristem is cut or covered, then the plant will not show any phototropism. The methodology of this experiment consists of 4 sections. The first 2 is testing phototropism, and the last 2 test out gravitropism in plants. The first experiment that I conducted, I grew garden cress plants with the light directly on top. On the other experiment, I shifted the light to the side to see if the plant has any reaction towards the light. In gravitropism, I grew 2 plants, one is upright and one to the side, with the light on top. The apparatus of this experiment consists of cardboard box, plexiglass, a camera, a tripod, and a light source. The plexiglass was cut in a dimension that is 1 centimeter in width. This will allow me to visualize the root formation to test out if the root responds to the light as well. Was cut out in the cardboard box to make sure that no other light source is going through the cardboard box to the plants. This will eliminate any external factors that will influence the results of the experiment. I chose garden cress to do my experiments on. This is primarily for one reason, which is garden cress. They grow really fast, they germinate relatively quick and easy. They take around 2 to 3 days to germinate, and it takes them around like 6 hours to grow. This is important for my experiments because I was planning to do the experiments, and if the results were questionable, I would do another experiment to test out my hypothesis. The result for the experiment where one plant is grown with a light on top and the other plant is grown on the with the light on the side is that the plants showed phototropism, however the root did not show any tropism at all. That means that the result was the root for both plants grew directly vertical to the plant, whether the light source is on top or to the side. What's interesting about the previous video, shows the gravitropism experiment. The plants took some time to react to the direction of the plant. In other words, it took them time to react to the light or to gravity. This means that auxin is produced, and the time took for for the plant to correct itself to move towards the light or against the gravity is the time for auxin reaching the cells and the cells actually elongating. The results of this experiment is that the videos showed phototropism in plants, and mostly all plants showed movement towards the light or movement that is influenced by light, except for the experiment where I cut off the meristem of one of the plants. The plant did show minimal phototropism, however it wasn't a significant amount of movement. This can be due to auxin already present in the plant shoot, which made it respond. In the same experiment, the plant that was covered, it showed phototropism similar to the control, which tells me that auxin is still produced, but since the shoot is not covered, the effect of phototropism is still apparent. Some areas to improve on in this experiment is to have a better gear, a better camera, or better equipment. I used common household items. I wanted to make this experiment as simple as possible, just to prove that an experiment can be done with minimal equipment. You don't need a lot of expensive equipment to create a scientific experiment or to experiment on plants. However, improvement could be made in this case. Better equipment could mean better results. And with this, I end my video. But before I do so, I wanted to thank my instructor, Dr. Brennan, for her amazing formative class, Plant Physiology. I learned a lot about plants in that lecture. And I will leave you now with some footage of plants' germination, which involve root formation and apical hook formation. Thank you.